Good morning and welcome to your Farm and Home Show. My name is Joanna Coles, and this morning we're going to talk about keeping beef production records. At the first of the year, we always think about things that we can do, maybe set some goals to improve our farming operation. And record keeping is certainly a big part of that. But today we're going to focus specifically on beef cattle record keeping. If you keep good records of your beef herd, then you can make great decisions as far as reproduction, production, and financial management decisions. But sometimes it's just hard to get started. So I would encourage you, if you're not already keeping records, go ahead and get started. But today we're going to just talk about the basics, some of the basic records that you need to keep for your beef cattle herd. And probably the top record keeping item that you need to keep is inventory. Most people keep an inventory. They know how many cattle they have on the farm, but we really need to break it down, and we also need to have it written down. We never know, we're not guaranteed tomorrow, and if something were to happen, we want to make sure that the people that are going to manage the farm and take care of it afterwards would be able to do so and know exactly the number and inventory on each particular farm. So inventory is as simple as the number of cows that you have, the number of calves, replacement heifers, and bulls that are on your property at the beginning of the year. If you buy cattle, or if you sell cattle, or if cattle happen to pass, keep those records of when that occurred in your cattle inventory, and that should make it easier to keep the other records if we have a good inventory, at least at the start of each year. But it would be great if we could keep a good running total of the number of cattle and where they are located on the farm. Also, the other big piece of record keeping is individual animal record keeping. Not only is it good for production records and financial records, but due to traceability requirements that we've had in the last several years, it's so important to know the birth date and the origin of where that animal was born. And if we've had any transport, or if we maybe purchased some cattle, know where we purchased and when. And there is an international numbering system. So there's a letter associated with each year that calf was born, and that's the first letter, and then you can either do it by birth order or with sire and dam information. That way, if you use that international numbering system, you're pretty much guaranteed not to have a calf with that same number for like 22 years. So it is a really good way not to duplicate and not to confuse yourself. But really, any way that you can identify those animals individually is great. So I say do what works best for you in your farming operation. But if you have cows, make sure to keep a record of when you acquired them, what their individual animal record is, and then you can keep all the other records that we'll talk about in a minute associated with that particular animal. If you have breed information, that could also be important just to have. Because the thing about it is, we always think we're going to remember. But if we go ahead and write that down, we won't have to really tax our brains to kind of remember exactly what happened with that individual animal. So we get those individual animal records, and then we move on into the breeding season. Breeding season is important. We need to know how many cows were exposed to which bull when. And then we can really go back when we're making decisions about reproduction, efficiency, those type of things. If we can see the number of cows that were exposed to which bull, it helps us make those decisions. Also, calving. Anytime we have a calf, if we can get that birth date recorded, and if you can't get the exact date, usually it's acceptable if you can get within 3 days of that birth date for that particular calf. If you have scales, that would be great to record that, but if you don't worry about it. Go ahead and get those production records written down, and then, like I say, we can always improve on our record keeping later. Now, one of the questions I get asked a lot is, how do I keep these records? Is there a software program, a book? What is the best way? And whatever way that you're actually going to keep the records is the best way. We have IRM books available at the Extension office. There's the NCBA Red Book production records. I have keep my production records on an Excel spreadsheet. So however you do that is better if it works for you, however you're going to do it. And then there are software programs on the computer that you can actually keep records on too. So if you have any questions about keeping beef records, contact your local Extension office, and we'd be happy to help you get a system that works for you. We appreciate you watching the Farm and Home Show, and hope you have a great day.